This is your neighborhood friendly Oxhorn, and today we are reviewing Subway Runner by Ghost FNCS. I believe that's his name. Ghost FC3S. That's his name. This is a brand new mod that popped up on the Nexus a few days ago. And this is a special broadcast. I'm broadcasting live. Those of you on YouTube right now, you don't see that I'm broadcasting live, but I'm broadcasting live right now, and I figured I would take you all with me to uncover and discover this new mod. So what this mod does is it creates a new series of subway systems underneath downtown Boston. Very similar to what we found in Fallout 3, which is pretty cool. Whoop, looks like I got some synths after me. Hold on, gotta hide a little bit. Anyway, it completely builds this underground network of subway tunnels from the ground up, and it's extremely exciting. Those of you on YouTube can't see this, but I've got the map up right now, and we're gonna start at the yellow line, which is just west of Green Top Nursery. And we're gonna go down the yellow line until we get to the red line, and then we'll follow the red line all the way down. That's the goal right now. Now, I don't know how long this is gonna take. I plan to broadcast for about an hour, and if you guys like this, then I may do more of it in the meantime. But for now, let us kill ourselves some synths. All right, so I'm assuming that this is the entrance to the terminal. This is the Malden Center subway terminal. And as you can see, Greentop Nursery is right over there. The blue line starts, no, the red line starts up here near Concord, and it goes down. So we're basically gonna be sneaking down this way to meet the red line and then following it down into downtown Boston. Elite Trooper says, a Sunday stream? Quite irregular. Yes, I'm trying something new. You'll all have to let me know what you think. Scrody One says, die synths. And I have to admit, I share the same sentiment. All right, here we go. Okay. Now, the mod author said that this is going to be really hard. I guess somebody's in here. Nope. Oh! Whoa! Goodness gracious me. Ah, man, I just can't. I just want to loot the area, guys. You know what? Bug off. Jeepers. Jiminy Crickets. I decided to rock my Sentinel suit of armor today just because I haven't worn it in a long time, and I was feeling very patriotic towards the Brotherhood of Steel for some reason. I've got my Atronus Gatling laser. Whoa! What is all going on? Look, a fat man! Looks like I can grab a fat man if necessary. Okay, so we've got a little gift shop over here. This guy built this thing from scratch, by the way. And it's really lightweight. It's just one ESP for the entire mod. It's super lightweight, downloads in a snap. I am more interested in exploring and kind of getting to the end of it, rather than exploring every nook and cranny, so. Although this is cool, what's down here? Running. Running. More running! Into synths! Oh, dear me. Ah! Holy cannoli. Elite Trooper says, this is your Brotherhood of Steel playthrough, I'm guessing? You are indeed correct. This is Ox. He's only level, like, 50-something. Okay, I basically just did a big circle, didn't I? And if I take those elevators, they're gonna take me up. But I don't want to go up, so I think I basically just went the wrong way. I want to go south. Let's see if we can find a way south. Did I see Kim's? I did. Chicknet out in Kim's. What? Am I stuck? Oh. Okay. Back where we started. All right, let's do this. Where's my cigar? There it is. Oh, wow, look at all these dead raiders. Okay, what in the actual tarnation? See, this is what I love about subway systems like this. And this is what I was really bummed that they didn't include in Fallout 4. I have extremely fond memories of running around... Why can't I move? Come on, why can't I move? There we go. I have extremely fond memories of running around in Fallout 3, getting completely lost inside the subway systems. And, you know, when I got into Fallout 4, that was missing. And I was so disappointed. But with this mod, he basically recreates that look and feel, but in Fallout 4. So I, for one, am excited to explore. Okay, looks like I went the right way the first time. We just got to kind of find our way through these side passages to get where we want to go. Ritesh Bansod is saying, what weapon is he using? I'm using the Aeternus Gatling Laser. It's a never-ending Gatling Laser, which means I never have to worry about running out of ammunition. And it looks like this elevator is the only way through. So let's go through the elevator. Okay. All right, looks like we're about to tunnel into some underground area here. Looks like we're about to find, a firefight between synths and raiders. Love this gun. I don't have to aim. I just have to point and click. Wow, this is really well done. Although this particular thing feels vaguely familiar. This is part of the game, isn't it? Well, let me finish exploring this little nook. Can I get the gun if I chose the good ending? No. Well, I mean, I can't answer that question confidently. All I can tell you is that after I chose the good ending on my other character, I no longer got the Amoral Combat quest. So I never got this gun on my female Minuteman build. So I'm assuming that yes, if you take the good ending, you no longer get Amoral Combat. Okay, looks like I have to go around the corner to that elevator. You get it from the gauntlet, though, says Duke Knight, and that's true, but you get it because of the Amoral Combat quest. But if you do the good ending and you kill all of the raiders, then, you know, I don't think that quest spawns anymore. What armor are you using, asks Michael Earl. I'm rocking my Brotherhood of Steel T-60 Sentinel suit. I have a mod equipped that I reviewed today that puts baggage and backpacks on the suit, and I'm using the visible weapons mod so that you can actually see my Gatling laser on my armor when I'm not using it. But you know what? I think I should probably use it. All right, that goes up. I'm assuming... Did I just do a big circle? I did. I just did a big circle. Alright, so the goal of this mod is that it... Hold on, let me check something. I gotta make sure that the plugin is activated in my load order. And it is. Alright, so... I thought this felt familiar. Okay, I'm confused. The mod said that this is supposed to be... That he connected all of the metro systems. This is a metro system. So, you'd think that it would be connected, right? So I just gotta find the way he connected it, or go to a different metro system, because I'm a little bit lost now. I basically went through everything. And is there something I missed? Elite Trooper says, I believe the area you're in at the moment is vanilla, and I agree, I believe it is. But this area is supposed to be connected to the new subway system. So, I should have tested this before I broadcasted, shouldn't I? Well, we all make mistakes. I just gotta find the connection. Where did he connect it? Not back here. Not back here. Not in here. Back here, maybe? Nope, not back here. And then this brings us back to the elevator, right? Yeah. So that's what I did there. Okay. Let's check the map again. Let's exit and check the map again. Because maybe there's a different entrance and I just didn't find it. What? Okay, where were we? Here we were. I'm gonna figure this out, ladies and gentlemen. Legate Australis says it would be cool if there was an entrance to the subway station in Vault 88. That would be cool. Okay, so taking a look at the map, and this is exactly where it's supposed to be, Malden Center. So, there's a connection to the yellow line at Malden Center. And then there's another one closer to Sanctuary over here somewhere in and around Concord. So let's go to Concord and see if we can find this. Mayumi says, is the mod even installed? Yes, it is installed. I just checked my plugins and Subway Runner NoDynamic.esp is installed and active. Look, there's a metro. Even if I can't get the mod to work, we're at least going to get a great tour of the metro system. Oh, look, and here we are. I guess we're going to have Preston talking to us. Oh, I love the Gatling laser. The beginning of the game is so much easier when you come back. All right. This is it? Is this it? What's this? Ooh, Concord Subway. I think we found it. All right. So we're going to start at the beginning of the red line and go on down. Did I just really start When Freedom Calls? I didn't mean to start When Freedom Calls. Gunners. Ooh. You know, with my main, I played her as a stealthy sniper. I was constantly hiding, always using VATS. And with this guy, I wanted the exact opposite. I was so tired of hiding in the shadows. I mean, I had a lot of fun with that character, and I still do. But I was really tired of hiding in the shadows just for everything. So I just wanted a guy where I could run around with my gun blazing, heedless of damage. And that's what I've done with this guy. This is new. I don't recognize this. This has got to be new. Hello? Is it me you're looking for? No. Yep. Oh, hi! Any more? Nope. Scrote asks, Oxhorn, how much time do you have in Fallout 4? An embarrassing amount. Whoa! Yep, this is the mod. That's not supposed to happen. Whoa! All right. Well, at least we know we're in the right spot. Okay, let's find our way through this thing. Ooh, hey, a power armor station. Yay! I don't need it right now, but yay! J. Modrak says, how much is an embarrassing amount? An embarrassing amount. That's how much an embarrassing amount is. It's so embarrassing and it's an embarrassing amount. I actually read off my played time during my live show on Thursday. And I forget what I said. So watch my live show to learn how much I've played this game. But I promise you, it's an embarrassing amount. Abandoned Subway. Here we go. Yeah, so far, those of you who have listed your hours played, I have you beat. Just saying. Not like it's a contest or anything. Oh! Ah! Oh! Oh my goodness gracious me. Gallery gumdrops. Die! With death! Die, die, die! Okay. Killed the raiders, but my cigar is dead. Hold on, let me fix this. Come on, cigar. Take the fire. There we go. This is what I like to see. Long, endless tunnels. All right, we're headed south, ladies and gentlemen. Let's see if we can get to Boston. Michael Valois says, die with death. Stop channeling Reaper, Ox. I know, Reaper is so emo. Oh! I get to kill a dog? Don't they say that's taboo? In film and TV, you're not supposed to kill the dog. But in video games, nothing is taboo. You can kill the dog. What? The great Azal says, is Ox reading Twitch chat? No. Yes, I am reading Twitch chat. Oh, man. Do I continue? Or do I go down the secret door? Do I continue? I continue. I gotta find out what's at the end of this tunnel. I wanna know. Gotta know. What is at the end of this tunnel? Ghouls. Oh, nope. Gatling laser, that's what this calls for. It's the Walking Dead, ladies and gentlemen. Oh no, and now they're behind me, right? Okay. Well, I think we found ourselves some ghouls, ladies and gentlemen. Have you ever thought of replaying Fallout New Vegas on hardcore? Yes, I have thought about replaying Fallout New Vegas. I loved that game. But, you know, I don't know what I could make in the terms of content. I do a lot of mods and settlement builds and stuff like that, but none of that is in New Vegas. And I wonder what I could do that hasn't already been done. Nope, I don't want to go to the Lexington subway station, but at least now I know where I'm at. We have gone from Concord to Lexington. Let's keep going. Oh, no, we're stuck. There's trash in our way. I wanted to keep going. Oh, man. Well, looks like we got to go to the Concord subway station, or the Lexington subway station, ladies and gents. Maybe that will allow us to continue forward. Oh, hi. The Great Azal says, so one of my new favorite mods is more unique. It practically doubles the amount of unique weapons, and they're all genuinely unique. What, it gives you more legendary effects? Oh, I see what it did. It just zoned me into the next part. I got you. I can keep going. All right. Do you play with multiple monitors so that you can read Twitch chat? It says Duke Knight. Ah! Yes, I do. I've got three monitors going right now. Hi. More ghouls. Hello, ghouls. Die, ghouls. Glowing one. Oh, glowing one. Oh, how you glow. More glowing ones. Oh, man. No. Oh, what is that? What is that? Stop with your glowing. Too much glowing, a glowing one. I don't need so much glowing. First stim pack of the broadcast, ladies and gentlemen. Eddie is the first stim pack of the broadcast. Okay. Oh, another glowing one. Oh, one that glows. Oh, hi. I'm so glad Atronus is a thing. I never have to worry about my fusion core ammunition ever again. I can just let it rip. That makes this build so much more fun. I also like this geometry exploit. I can shoot them and they can't get me. Oh. What is that sound? I heard a sound. It sounds like ghouls. It sounds like legendary ghouls. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on. Die! Woo! Boy, howdy. I heard something next to me. Oh, yeah. They're literally around every corner. This is creeping me out. Let's go onward. More of the abandoned subway. I'm still going south, right? Yeah, I am. That's good. More ghouls to kill. There is no such thing as too few ghouls to kill. Ah, there we go. And the way is free at last. Elite Trooper says, do you think Atronus isn't meant to be truly unlimited, though? I feel like Bethesda may have screwed up, and it's meant to be this way. Well, I mean, it does say never-ending Gatling gun. Unlimited unlimited ammo capacity. I guess that doesn't really say never-ending Gatling gun. Just die in this rain of fire I thrust upon you. Please stop getting up. Sheepers. At least it's not an exploit. I'm using the gun as it was made. Okay, another dead end. Another dead end. Alright, well, right away. A door! Oh, we go down. Down, down, down. Ah! Oh, more! From the shadows. That seems like a really creepy dark hallway. Oh, hi. Did I disturb you? Did I bring you from your slumber? Yes! And I brought your friends! No, 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 no. Oh, man, they're on me! Tiptoe through the ghoul piles and their goo piles. All right, I got my buff out. I got my chems. I don't want to die. I'm not going to die. I got full health, and I'm in power armor. I'm power armor. You could get lost in a place like this. Oh, hi. Wrong way. Which way did I come from? This is exactly what I loved about Fallout 3. You get lost. And I think I've been there. Did I come from here? Yes, I did, because I'm going north now. I want to go south. Keep going south. South, south, south. Let's keep going south. Oh, and off to the side. And up the stairs. And through the door. It's like the gauntlet all over again. What? Wait, what? What? Oh. it's another blocked passage, so I should keep going down. You know, what's interesting is none of these legendary, none of these legendary creatures have had any legendary a few of them have, never mind. I got confused. Whoa! Stop pawing at me, buddy! Get your filthy ghoul mitts off me. Alright, this way. This is a dark and spooky hall. I love it. Did I find the way out? Yep. Okay. The storm won't open, will it? It will. Alright, so we passed Lexington, and we're still going south. Where do you guys think we are now, huh? There's a thing on me! With the things! Gosh, that guy just won't die! No! Okay. Alright, I'm making the Brotherhood proud, ladies and gents. I'm killing all the ghouls. Taking all the buff out. How's my armor doing? My armor's doing okay, right? Yeah, it's doing alright. Next time I come across a, power armor station, I may want to take advantage of it. College Square Station. I don't want to go up, though. I want to keep going. But maybe I have to go through here. Rabbit Death Knight says College Square, I'd say. You called it, sir. Kudos to you. Whoa, what? How did you get behind me? You booger! Alright. College Square. We are the college in the square with the squares in the college. Great. Back to the abandoned subway. Let's keep on going. Taylor Ritchie says, why are you not checking the legendary creatures for their legendary items? Well, hold on. I'm busy. the reason is because I do not plan to keep this game save. The way I play my game is I really love mods like this. I like playing them, but I kind of want to keep my game free of cheating. So I love this mod. It is such a cool mod, but it's giving me an opportunity to farm more legendary items than I think Bethesda would really intend me to ever get. And, you know, you get a lot of legendary items that they've dropped like candy in the game, so it's really not that big of a deal. But, you know, I just don't want to really have access. I don't want to keep in my inventory a bunch of loot that I got from a mod when I could have just gotten it from regular gameplay. Does that make sense? I don't know if that makes a lot of sense, but that's kind of the way I'm going about this. So I'm going to play this mod, but I probably won't keep this game save when I'm done. Alright, keep going down the train cars. Sounds like synth and super mutants. Having a blast. Well, we've got pretty lights, ladies and gents. Second stim pack of the day. Okay, so not that way. Ooh. Not that way. That way. I hear things. Got him. Wow, these guys are really dumb. Is that it? Nope, more to come. Holy cannoli, this is a lot of super mutants. Ouch. Level up, Buttercup. They just kept coming and coming. This is another reason why I don't keep game saves like this, because it gives you access to more experience than you would otherwise find in the game. I mean, this is basically never-ending super mutants, ghouls, and synths and stuff. So I could potentially download a mod like this and farm my way to a very high level. Ah, that's where he is. Okay. D Hunt says, hey, what's up, Oxhorn? Surprised to see you on a Fallout stream. Yeah, I'm just as surprised as you. But hey, you know what? The world is amazing. D Hunt says, hey, I gotta say, I borrowed your rail car tower idea, and I made some tweaks. It's looking great. Thanks for the idea. You're welcome. My pleasure. Duke Knight says, Ox, what's your favorite grenade in Fallout 4? What, besides the nuke grenade? I like the plasma grenade. I like the noise it makes. Yeah. That... Didn't expect to get that one. Whoop! Are the things behind me? Yep. I'm still going south, right? Yeah, I am. Alright. Small Bowser says, Oxhorn, why do you only have 3 weapons? Because I really don't want to carry my entire inventory around with me. Plus, this gun has never-ending ammo. I'm still on 27 fusion cores, as you can see. And I really don't need all these weapons to carry around with me. Now, when I first, you know, when you first start playing the game, ammunition is so rare that, of course, you have to carry tons of weapons around with you just to get through the game. But in later stages of the game, after you've collected a lot of ammunition and you've invested in scavenger and nuclear physicist, ammunition becomes so much easier to get and it lasts a lot longer. You really don't need to carry all these weapons with you. So I've got my missile launcher for long-range issues and my Gatling laser for everything else. Scorch says, hey, Octron, what's your favorite gun slash rifle and your favorite perk? Well, for my sniper, it's hard to beat the Gauss rifle. But if I had to pick my most... If I had to pick the one that I like the most in terms of aesthetics, it would be the lever action rifle from Far Harbor. Triggerman? He put Triggerman in here? That's so cool. You don't get to see Triggerman in later stages of the game. Penetrating super sledge. Ox, you're one of my favorite Fallout YouTubers, says Eric Ortz. Why, thank you so much. I do appreciate it. Lego Kip Gaming says, what's the best armor besides power armor? And I actually solved that in a video. The answer is Disciples armor is the best armor next to power armor. It's better than combat. It's better than... Wait a minute. I know this place. Is Vault 8... Is there a vault around here somewhere? Wait a minute. I think I've been here before. I am consuming my fusion cores, but at a much slower rate. The only thing consuming my fusion cores is sprinting, jetpack. Yeah! Yeah, this is the vault! Hey, there's the vault! That's where Nick Valentine was kept. I knew I recognized this place. So, the mod connected it to the vault. That is so cool. So, I'm right beneath downtown Boston. This door must lead me through the rest. Yes, and on to the abandoned subway. Oh, hey, buddy. Farmer Play says, you have put out some very well put together and informative videos. Thanks for the hours of enjoyment, Oxhorn. You are welcome. Thanks so much for joining me today. Okay, I'm feeling a sense of doom and foreboding. Or I'm feeling a foreboding sense of doom. Or I'm dooming a sense of foreboding. I don't know. Okay, so that goes down, but that goes north. That's blocked. That's where I came from. That's blocked. And that's blocked. There's the answer. How many more DLCs do you think are going to be released, says Sajanarkiboo. And, well, sadly, this is the last one. Well, Nuka World was the last one. They officially announced that. Now, they could have been lying. I wouldn't bet on it, though. I think that's it. Hey. Looks like I missed some raiders. Bummer. Gunner. That worked. Oh man, I'm getting cigar ash all over my keyboard. Imagine Boo says, well, there's always a chance for more DLC until the next game comes out. There's always a chance, but again, they've officially come out and said that there will not be. So, you know. So I wouldn't, again, I wouldn't count on it. It's always possible. All right. Kevin Dubon says, Ox, do you use the Train Pain perk? I do. I got it early on in my playthrough. But to be honest, I don't use it a whole lot. And we're blocked. Enter through exit only. It's not a game changer for me. Is it worth the perk point? Maybe. It's kind of cool. But, I don't use it a lot. Okie doke. I can't see. I'm blind. Fire blindly into the void. Surprisingly effective. Third stim pack of the stream. Duke Knight says, the fact that Bethesda experimented with multiplayer means that there is net code for this game. Give it time and there will be a multiplayer mod. Whoa, that would be really cool. I would love to be able to show off my settlements to players, you know, and let them join me in my world. But, you know, it is a single player game. Oh, hi. Oh no, my arm is red! I gotta find a power armor station. Is there one in here? The nice thing about Pain Train is it does stun them for a brief period of time, allowing my Gatling laser to wind up. Alright, somebody get me a power armor station. I need a power armor station. Nothing. Bubkiss. Well, Jiminy Crickets. Looks like this is the way. Thank you. Spray and pray. Still no power armor station. Well, we can cross our fingers and hope for the best. Oh, and we're stuck. Okay, I'm going north. Stuck there too. There we go. There's one over here. Nope. Me. Aha. What? Raiders aren't going to have a power armor station, are they? Well, they've got the Raider power armor, maybe. I'm randomly grabbing scrap that I might need if I... Whoop! This is like a mirage. At the end of the tunnel, I keep seeing these lights, but that's just an illusion. It just keeps going and going. Tom Allen says, what's going on, Oxhorn? Not much. Doing a little bit of Fallout 4. This is a really cool mod called Subway Runner. Oh, hi! Adds a lot of really cool content to the game. Why do they like mannequins so much? Well, what was that? Almost died there. Ladies and gents, I'm boned. I made a stupid mistake of trying to pain train that machine gun turret. And I lost all my armor pieces except my chest and right arm. Come on, Luck. Oh man, I need a power armor station. All right. I don't even remember killing that dog. This looks vaguely familiar. Is this a thing? Yeah, there's a terminal. This must be, I've been here before, ladies and gentlemen. I recognize this. Let us see if there's a power armor station up here. You're at Andrew Station, says Sanjekar. South Boston. All right, let's see what's upside. I believe there is a power armor station at Andrew Station, am I right? Yes, that's where we're at. Okay. Oh no, and it glitched on me. I used up my fusion core. And it glitched on me. Okay, I believe there's one up here. Man, there isn't. Something's going on, though. So we're at Andrew Station. Fusion core removed? What's going on? I had 27 fusion cores. Suddenly, okay, am I getting that glitch? All right, I'm going to go back to my home base. Let's see. All right, so we managed to move all the way from Concord to Andrew Station, which is where we're at now. If I can find it. Right there. Is that the end? I don't know if it goes any further south. Let me consult my map. Yeah, that's it. That's as far south as it goes. I think that was the end, ladies and gents. So that was the red line of Subway Runner. And I am eating through fusion cores like it's nobody's business. Got him. I don't understand why there's all this activity going on right now. Let's figure out what it is. I've noticed that if you try to run towards the sound of gunfire, that you oftentimes don't actually get to the right spot. And I'm out of ammo again. What the heck? Well, this is the glitch with the Atronus. I covered this extensively in my video on it. There you go, a pain train kill. Just for you. And this is on fire. Oh, I see what it was. No, that's my pack buddy. Hey there, pack veteran guy. Okay. Well, there we are, ladies and gents. That was the end of Subway Runner. It was a whole lot of fun. And I just wanted to show it off. That was the red line. And there are... No, that was the blue line. That was the blue line. All the way from the Concord Station down to Andrews Station. But there's the yellow line and the red line. So that's not even the end of it. But sadly, that is the end of this broadcast. I am going to upload this video to YouTube so that you guys can check it out in the future if you want. It's a really cool mod. I'm going to link to the mod in the description of this video if you too would like to explore Subway Runner and check out all of the cool, unique subway, underground subway tunnels that you can explore. David Clarkson says, will you be playing Skyrim? At some point, I will indeed. At some point. But right now, I'm still too preoccupied with Fallout to do anything else. I'm still loving the game. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for coming to this live stream. Be sure to tune into my weekly live show, Scotch and Smoke Rings. It airs every Thursday at 7 o'clock p.m. Pacific time here on my YouTube channel or at twitch.tv/scotchandsmokerings. Until next time, ladies and gentlemen, I will bid you all adieu. I have a new video scheduled for tomorrow morning, just like every morning. I publish a new video every day. And until next time, ladies and gentlemen, be sure that each and every one of you stays classy.